It is a big night for the voters to get a good look at some of the candidates vying to run our state.
Coming up at 8 o'clock tonight, the four GOP candidates for governor will go head to head in a debate right here in this studio. Devin Scillian will be moderating. Mara McDonald will be covering it, and they're joining us now with a primer on the candidates and the issues. Hey, guys.
Hey there. We expect a pretty fascinating night, Mark, because, of course, this is the last official debate before the primary. We've still got more than a month to go before primary election.
It's also the debate in the biggest media market in the whole state. So if anybody is going to make any points, it's going to be tonight.
Well, we've got our baseball cards. So let's start with Brian Calley, if we can. Lieutenant Governor. Of course, Lieutenant Governor through the entire Snyder administration. I think to many, this might seem like his campaign might seem like a referendum really on the Snyder years, right?
Well, he's also got some problems ahead of him. You know, Calley pre-Snyder administration, reputation, nice guy of the Michigan legislature, autism activist.
Right, got a daughter with autism.
Exactly, and an advocate. But you also have things like he voted to expand Medicaid in Michigan. That doesn't play well with Republican primary voters.
Yeah.
And then there is that whole part-time legislature campaign that went precisely nowhere.
Yeah, exactly.
But he does come in here tonight with the second best name ID and the second best money.
Yeah, let's move on.
Patrick Colbeck, this one is interesting. Republican, Western Wayne County, very poor name ID overall in the state, yet probably the most conservative guy in this whole race.
Yes, one of the leading voices against any kind of expansion of Obamacare, or Obamacare in general, and has been really trying to make a lot of noise, really on a lot of the Trump priorities right now.
Yep, but he also has been really stepping in it as far as social issues go. Just recently, he was supporting conspiracy theories, unfounded conspiracy theories about one of the Democratic candidates who happens to be a Muslim. That was a big problem. He got repudiated by his own party for that, as well as being called a pathetic, bigoted fool by the Democrats.
Let's talk about Dr. Jim Hines. Fascinating life, really interesting cat. Regardless of how you feel about his politics, OBGYN, who would be the first physician ever elected governor, but a really interesting guy, was a missionary for a while in Africa along with his wife, licensed pilot.
Drives a Harley?
Drives a Harley, really interesting.
OBGYN, seven sons. He is the only non-politician in the GOP stable who is running. He will tell you he is a long shot to get this nomination. He realizes that he has put a substantial amount of his own money into this race. Whether it's enough to have, you know, TV time,
trickier.
Likely no.
And the guy who's been the front runner in the polls.
And who is continuing to be the front runner in the polls. The guy with the most name ID, the most money, and the most critical endorsements. That said, if he has all this name ID, why are still so many Republicans undecided at this point?
Good question. And perhaps some of those decisions will be made this evening. Be sure to watch the debate, 8 o'clock, right here on Local 4. When it ends, we hope you'll head over to clickondetroit.com. Kimberly Gill will have Reaction hosting a live webcast. Big night here at Local 4. Guys?